joyful to see all of you here and to have such a full church. We come to worship God, to give thanks for the gift of Jesus, his son, born at Bethlehem for us this day, as we come together to celebrate the presence of our Lord Jesus in word and in sacrament. Our first carol today is O Little Town of Bethlehem, which is number 497. Let's, if you're able to stand to sing, please, let's stand to sing.
Light it from the parcel candle, which is above, and so on. And then you have
ways to love God and to love each other as we love ourselves, to value one another and to remember that we are all God's children. If you'd like to put the pink one for me, please. This one is for John the Baptist, who was the last of the prophets, who was called to prepare the way of the Lord, who was coming immediately before Jesus. The last purple candle is for Mary. I'm going to ask you to light this. So, Mary's yes to God, may our yes to God possible in Jesus. And this last candle is for... This candle is for Jesus, the light of the world, whose birth we celebrate. So thank you so much. And so finally we come to the last of the candles of the Advent wreath. And there is a prayer for each of the candles, but the one we have there is for Christmas Day. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, light of light, you have come among us. Help us who live by your light to shine as lights in your world. Glory to God in the highest. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
Jesus is our way.
With Jesus, even dark places are light.
Jesus is the truth.
In Jesus we shall live forever.
Jesus is our life.
And so as we gather to celebrate his presence with us once more in word and in sacraments, we gather for communion to share in the body of Christ, which is what we are. We begin by confessing our sins. All those times in our lives when we have fallen short of his call upon us, whether in our words and our actions and our thoughts. Christ, the light of the world, has come to dispel the darkness of our hearts. In his light, let us examine ourselves and confess our sins. Christ came in humility to share our lives. Forgive our pride.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ came with good news for all people. Forgive our silence.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ came in love to a world of suffering. Forgive our self-centeredness.
Lord, have mercy.
May God the Father forgive us our sins and bring us to the fellowship of his table with his saints forever.
Amen.
And so we have the collect prayer for Christmas Day. Lord Jesus Christ, your birth at Bethlehem draws us to kneel in wonder at heaven touching earth. Accept our heartfelt praise as we worship you, our Saviour and our eternal God. Amen.
Amen.
So we come to our first reading from the letter to Titus. To our gospel reading.
to you, O Christ.
Delicately feeding it with a little bit extra make sure it's just spot on. Do this, and we get ready. When the moment comes, the surprise, the wonder, the fantasticness, if there is such a word, of it all. Mary knew that Jesus was coming. God knew that Jesus was coming. But do you know what? He didn't book ahead, did he? Because Airbnb didn't materialise for them. It was more like stable B&B. And only then, out of push. And there wasn't a great deal of security about it all, because after the wise men had been, Joseph was told, right, get up, off you go, get the donkey, you're going to Egypt for a few years because Herod wants to kill Jesus. It's a bit challenging. Always on the move, never quite knowing what comes next. Sounds a bit like real life, doesn't it? Actually, because we never know what's quite going to come next. And even though you probably have most of today mapped out, I bet there will be at least one surprise for every single person here. And if there isn't, come on, we've got to manage it. The lovely thing about Christmas is that it reflects the love and peace of God. It doesn't need to be perfectness of God. Because at Christmas, nobody really minds if things go a little bit hair-shaped. Nobody really minds if things are a little bit messy. Nobody really minds that much if the children wake you up at 5 a.m. Because, well, it's Christmas. And nobody really says you have got to go to bed on time. Because it's Christmas. And nobody minds if grandpa or, well, not to be stereotypical, mum decides to snore in front of the television later on in the afternoon because we're all completely and utterly exhausted. It's okay because it's Christmas. Wherever you have found yourself this year, and whatever interesting pickles you may have found yourself in, or indeed whatever pickle you still are in, at Christmas, perhaps we can lay aside the worry for just a moment and be present. Present to one another, just as we give presents to each other. We give presents because Jesus gave us God gave us the present, sorry, of Jesus. And that's the wonderful thing about the word present. It means both a gift, a thing which I give to you, but it's also the most precious thing we can give to one another. Being present. Being truly attentive. Being truly with each other. Christmas isn't an easy time for everybody, and actually, sometimes corralling the entire family with all these quirks and eccentricities and other things into one house for an extended period of time can be a little trying. You know, I didn't break it this way, you do it that way, but hang on, that's not the right way to do roast potatoes, whatever it may be in your house. But actually, despite all of our differences, we can be present with one another as we celebrate that greatest gift of presence, the presence of God. Nothing has to be perfect. God didn't make sure that everything was perfect before he turned up. We might have waited a while before Jesus came, but he came at just the right moment. And he helps us sort out the messes in our lives and help us get ready for whatever it is that comes next. Wherever this coming year may take you, wherever the past year has brought you. May you know that God is with you in the ordinariness, in the not quite done roast potatoes, in the gosh, I forgot to do this, that, and the other, in the I just tripped over a Lego brick in my bare feet. Yeah, you all know that feeling. With all those who are struggling and suffering, as well as with all those who celebrate, with all those who are homeless, and don't know where to go, even as with those of us who have plenty, and God willing, may share that plenty with others. May you know God's peace. So let us stand to affirm God's loving kindness to us and his presence with us in words. We believe
and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist. We believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again. We believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us sit or kneel for our prayers as we gather, making our prayers to God, Father, through Jesus Christ, his Son, and the Holy Spirit. Light to everyone who is called to work for peace and give them your wisdom. We ask you to send your love to everyone who is not sure of God's love and reassure them. And we ask you to send your love to everyone who is called to serve God away from home at this time. So I'm going to, for a moment, invite you to share the peace in a thoroughly Anglican cuddle. without necessarily taking anything. Just work with the theory. Christ came and proclaimed the gospel. Peace to those who are far off and peace to those who are near. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace as we
thank you.
is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord. It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is right to praise you, Father, Lord of all creation. In your love you made us for yourself. When we turned away, you did not reject us, but came to meet us in your Son. You embraced us
as your children, and welcomed us to sit and eat with you.
In Christ you shared our life, that we might live in him and he in us.
He opened his arms of love on the cross and made for all the perfect sacrifice of sin.
On the night before he prayed, at supper with his friends, he took bread and gave it thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His body is the bread of life.
At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you shall drink it, in remembrance of me."
Father, we do this in remembrance of him. His blood is shed for all.
Another 50 in. Where's the grandchild? Where's the grandchild?
Lost him.
Yeah.
Finally.
That responsibility. Oh.
eternal life. I ask you into my life and heart to be my Lord and Savior. I must serve you always. Amen. God our Father, whose word has come among us in the Holy Child of Bethlehem, may the light of faith illumine our hearts and shine on our words and deeds, through him who is Christ the Lord. Amen.
Next Sunday.
Thank you.